Good morning, guys. So this is our second morning in Paris. I know that I didn't film the journey here, but nonetheless, we are here, and right after this, I'm gonna insert a clip of what the place looks like. It's a really nice place. Cold, but it's really nice, to be honest. It's a beautiful neighborhood. It's a little bit outside of the central area. So it gives a different vibe versus like the city life. So it's nice, it's green here, it's beautiful. I'm gonna show you guys as we go down to head to the train station, because this morning we are going to do a hop on hop off bus. I know that's a touristy thing, but we tourists, so we're gonna do that. After which I'm not sure how much we could fit in after that, but normally we are also going to an exhibition, an art exhibition, Van Gogh, which is something that I really wanted to see. So I hope I could film inside so you guys can see how cool it is, and that should be most of our day. And then we'll do things tomorrow, God's willing, and the day after. So I hope that you guys are ready. If you are interested in seeing what we are about to be doing in Paris, then keep watching. So this is the outside porch, like terrace area, and then once you enter, you have the toilet that's here by itself. Then you have the closet where we have a vacuum and all the stuff that we may need in that sense. Then we move along to here being the living room with the window that it opens up to the terrace. That's the couch, another couch. Here's where we have the TV and so forth. Then here we are in the kitchen. Here is where the fridge is, and other stuff, of course, are in there, which he explained. Then we move along to the bedroom. So here is the bedroom. So this is what it's looking like with the bathroom connected. So in terms of like the vanity, and the shower is also here with a little rug. So this is what the place is looking like. It's not bad at all. Actually, it's really cool. It's really cozy. But unfortunately, it's really far from like supermarkets and so forth, but we'll make it work. So we made it to our stop, well, one of the stops at Trocadero. I don't know how it's supposed to be pronounced. Why are you reading it in Spanish? So we see the bus that's here, hop on, hop off bus. So we're hoping to hop on it now and see where all we can go. Because apparently you could catch it anywhere, and it's like every 5 to 10 minutes. So this one looks a little full though. I'm not sure we're gonna go on that one. So yeah, let me show you. So guess what? Wrong bus. Oh, so now I see the bus that we're actually supposed to take. It's that one we actually have to take. But we're already at the spot where we can see the Eiffel Tower from far. So we said we might as well just see it, and then we jump on the bus when the next one arrives. Just look at it, guys. It's so amazing. So beautiful. You think I never saw it before, but I mean, when I saw it, I was like, well, how old I could have been? 11? Or something like that. So it wasn't the same, you know? So as you can see, there are a lot of people here right now. Everyone's probably doing that picture. Everyone is probably doing the picture where, you know, you put your finger to the top. So here's a closer view of the fountain down below and so forth. This is someone's dream come true. What are your words?
I have no words. It's just such a, you know, exciting moment. And yeah, I don't want to say.
All right, guys, so we made it onto the bus. So our first area where we were, as I told you, was the Tocadero area. So next, we are pulling up to the Eiffel Tower. And you guys will see from there where we go. Alright, guys, so we just hopped off of the bus at the stop Arc de Triomphe, as you can see behind me. So I'm sure before this you guys saw all the different things that we saw. It's been a beautiful day. Actually, it's hot, but we're happy that we were able to see all the sights in one day, one chant. And of course, after having seen them as such, we can decide after which ones we want to go back and visit. For example, we know that we're going back to see the Eiffel Tower because we're going to actually climb it, and then we're going to go back to Trocadero. And I'm not sure where else, maybe this same Arc de Triomphe, we might climb it and take the view of Paris. So right now we're just gonna get something to eat before we head to the art exhibition, because it's in about 2 hours, we have to be there. So food, as usual, then the art exhibition. So we are now pulling up to the place that I've been longing to go to. Kenisha got her dream. Yeah, Kenisha got her dream. I seen the Eiffel Tower. Now it's my turn. So we are gonna see the works of Van Gogh just all over. Watching the exhibition, and it was really a dream come true for me, in a sense where, I mean, I'm not a big artsy person, but I saw that online and I was like, that's something that I have to experience. I mean, I find it to be more interesting than just watching art pieces at a museum. Like, it was animated, as you guys would have seen in the clips before. It was animated, it was changing, there was music, so there was like everything that was involved, and it was just all around you, so it's almost like you couldn't avoid it, and you were just like immersed in the whole painting. You felt like you were there in those moments based on how the music was and all that. So I recommend those of you who may be coming to Paris that you definitely check out the exhibition. It'll be running until I think September or December, so it's definitely worth checking out. After this, we are normally heading back home, and that'll be it for this day. So I'll end the vlog now by saying bye, guys. Good morning, guys. Actually, no, it's afternoon. Good afternoon from Paris. So today is a big day for us because, I mean, how do you come to Paris and you not climb the Eiffel Tower? Like, how do you do that? But you know what's really special about this, though, is that we are not taking the elevator. We are actually walking up the stairs. Because why? I mean, this is not by choice, to be honest. What happened was that we never knew that we had to book it like that. So the elevator rides were kind of booked out. So it's like, we only have the choice to walk. So imagine us climbing up 700 and something stairs. Yeah, imagine that. I can't imagine it either. So let's see if we actually make it. So that is our task today. That's where we're headed to. That's what we're gonna do. So stay tuned as we make it to the Eiffel Tower and hopefully make it up to the top where we want to be. So guys, we made it to the area with the Eiffel Tower, but we had to make a food stop because on the way over here, I started to not feel as good. So I decided I should get something to eat, especially if we're gonna climb the Eiffel Tower by stairs. It's gonna be kind of hard to do if I'm not feeling well. So we went to that stand that you see behind right there, got us some crepe. I also got a hot dog. I guess Kenesha wasn't as hungry, but I personally need, no, I want my crepe though. I need the sweet to get up. So yeah, so we're just eating now and then gonna try to do this thing. I literally dreading this thing, but we gotta do something daring, something out there, something drastic. That'll help us to always remember this place. We might not want to see the Eiffel Tower for a while after that, you know, but we'll definitely remember it. Upstairs, you would think that not many people would be, you know, trying to do that, but you have a good amount of people like we in a line that we where we might be for the next 30 minutes, 45 minutes. And that's kind of strange, but at least we won't be alone in this suffering, to be honest. So another 45 minutes or so and then the journey begins. Not like we're in a rush for it, but should be fun, should be interesting, mostly interesting though. I'm sure you guys would notice that my attire kind of changed, you know? Being close to the Eiffel Tower made me want to be a little patriotic with my blue and white and red. So, you know. And so, guys, the journey begins. There we go, first steps. How you feeling now? This isn't your dream place. We still doing it regardless. We done start, we were already there. We don't quit. So we just read it. There are 328 stairs until the first story. Mm-hmm. My legs aren't burning me now. Maybe I've gone anywhere, to be honest.
Look at human being. Look at
she don't walk in slow because she just enjoy the view, you know. Those slow movements. Look, we just even leaving people pass. Those slow movements signify tired
legs.
When I tell y'all, legs burning, are ya? I don't know. We almost there? Yeah. Yeah, huh? Yeah. We made it. Welcome. Yes, we made it to the first floor. It was hard, but we did it. I feel so accomplished. Can't guarantee that the second floor happening, but you know, this is definitely worth it. We're gonna now go step on the glass floor to look down at the view from up here. So this is a view from up here on the first floor, from the inside at least. We'll check out the outside by going by the side glasses to see what the outside part looks like. So to make it up to this point, we, as I said, it was 328 stairs, but to go to the second floor is even more stairs. So physically, I don't know. I feel like we're gonna be taking some breaks, some much needed breaks, but I don't think that we're gonna give up. We came here to do this, so we are definitely just gonna finish what we started. We just gotta do it, you know? They say nothing is impossible with God, so we could do this. So here we go, up to the second floor. Okay, I'm just trying to not stop. Just keep going. Oh my God, Kenesha, it's nowhere to be seen, you know. I'm just getting dark in it. You know you're coming to an end. I can see the light up there. So near, Nadine, and just like that, I made it. Guys, I made it. I just have to say it a few more times so I can believe it. Can I tell you? I'm so tired that I haven't even looked at the view. Could barely see it. I can see it, like, you know, slightly through the cages, but I used to know. Not even sure how we're getting home, because that's the next walk that is burning your legs too. Lord help us. So this is the view from the northern side. So you see the fountain, and then straight ahead up there is Trocadero, where you could stand and take the picture with the, looking like you're holding the tip of the Eiffel Tower. Of course, here is the Seine again, just from a different view, different angle. Beautiful, guys. Definitely beautiful. Definitely was worth it. I think had we seen this by night, it would have been even more beautiful, but nonetheless, we're soaking in all that we can right now. So overall, I can say that though this was really challenging, I think it's definitely worth it. It reminds me of where we were in Turkey, in Istanbul, and we had the view from the top of the Gala Tower. It wasn't the same in the sense that you got up with, we walked the stairs? We took an elevator that time, so it's not the same experience. This definitely was a workout. But the thing is, like, if we can do it, if Kenesha and I could do it, you can do it. That's what I think, because for people who don't work out, to be able to get up here by stairs, anybody could do this. I saw kids doing this. Like, I'm like, you know, I was worried about them now. So it's like, why would the parents put them through this? But kids came up here like it was nothing. Nothing whatsoever. But if you guys can get the chance to go up to the summit, some of you, then definitely do that. We were not able to book any tickets to get to the top, but I think that if you can, you should definitely do it. I mean, the view from here is amazing too, but I can imagine what it's like from the top, you know? So although we came up the steps, going back down, there's definitely elevator vibe. We want to make it home today by walking. We can't walk down those stairs. So just a little hint, as you guys saw, we came down the elevator, although we went up the stairs. So for those of you who may be interested in going up using the stairs, just know that no one really monitors, like, if you have a ticket for elevator when it's time to go down. So just use the elevator. So normally we want to see the Eiffel Tower light up, so we determined to stay out until it does. Problem is that sun only sets 9:30 minutes to 10. So right now it is 8:30. We definitely have to try to burn an hour or so still. But we were like right next to the Eiffel Tower, we found this I don't know what to call it. It's like a little shopping area, but it says food, drinks and chill. So it's like it almost looks like a little fair type of thing, where there's like souvenir stores, all of that, and then the Eiffel Tower was like right there, like right there. So if you look behind me, you'll see what I was talking about. So this is what it's looking like behind there. So we're just pretty much gonna chill here for a while and then head up to Trocadero, that's that way, in order to watch the Eiffel Tower as the light show goes on, because we feel like we couldn't leave here without seeing the light show. So we're definitely looking forward to seeing the Eiffel Tower by night. Someone never tasted macarons. They didn't even know what it was. Like, how do you come to France and not know what these are? So we're gonna have her taste one now, at least so she could get a taste of Paris for real, for real. Miss?
That's not au present.
Yes. So let's see.
Thank you.
How it tastes? Tastes good? Oh, there you go.
So you guys not ready, right? We came in here, so you know there's food. We definitely eating, right? So we got some kebab, fries. It's a little taste of Greece, a little taste of Turkey, you know, those places. So it's about to go down, you know.
So disregard the lane. So as I told you, yeah, we were waiting for the sun to set so that we could see the Eiffel Tower light up. I want to tell you, there are so many people here.
As those other billion people waiting as well.
Like, we didn't think that there would be so many people here right now. Like, when I say people, like, people either down on the boats, like, going through the river, or they over at Trocadero. Like, they move or from over there, like, over there. Just from far, all you see is, like, dots, like, ants over there. And then even around us here on the bridge, everybody's here. This is, like, literally, like, the hot spot to be at. I guess especially because it's weekend time, but Lord, like, really, we wanted to go up there to see it light up, and I feel like now I feel like over there, like, we haven't even, like, you're gonna be fighting to see the play. I prefer just stay right here and just watch it happen, because that walk over there just to be choked up with a bunch of people, you know why.
There she goes, guys. She started to light up. Part of what we've been waiting for. I really want to see a twinkle. I want to see the show. But this is definitely so beautiful.
And there she goes, guys. Exactly on the hour. So beautiful. It's definitely worth seeing. In person, like, this camera is not doing it justice.
So folks, we just got back home. That walk from the train station to here was just the icing on the cake. Like, that's it, my legs dead, pack up. I just talking because tomorrow said we have to leave the house once again. But yeah, this is our last vlog. This ends our July vlog time and also the 3 times a week thing. So it's been fun. It's been work, but we're back to our regular schedule, which is twice a week. So twice a week, and maybe there may be an occasional vlog, I don't know, but we gonna come with different content now. But I encourage all of you to check out all that we've been through thus far, what we experienced, where we went, all those things. And thank you for all of your support throughout this month and throughout all the vlogging, all your comments, your likes, your shares, all of that. It's been a really good journey, and fortunately it has to end. Work life begins, we go back to reality. You know how that is. But thank you guys for tuning in, and that is it. Not just for tonight, it is it until, you know? So sayonara, folks.